Hello, YouTube. This is another question on finding the true shape of a lamina, and it's a typical WAEC question. I will set it here in West Africa. It reads, two views of a triangular lamina are given in the first angle projection in the figure below. Figure below. A, draw the true shape of the triangle. B, measure and state the length of the sides of the triangle, and C, determine the angle that the plane makes with the HP, that is a horizontal plane. This is more like the problem I've solved before, but the difference is what I'm going to show you shortly. This was the one I solved before, and we found out that this line AB has a true length in the front view. But in this case, we have nothing to show that any of these lines are actually a true length found in any of the views, either front in the elevation or in the plan view. None of them actually shows that. So, as is the case with auxiliary views, we would also look at another way to solve this problem, and some of the steps that we're going to go through is what I've written right here. The first step is to find the true length or create one. Project through the true length to get an edge view, that is the first auxiliary view. And then step three, to draw the second auxiliary view to get the true shape of the triangular lamina. Now, the difference is that we have to create something that looks like a true length or a length within the triangle and has to be parallel with the reference plane. That's why. So let's see what we can do with that. In the previous one, I think I did something of the sort. If we took B, for instance, we would have B hitting AC. At this point, and I will project that down, or alternatively, we could do this same thing hit here, and then we have the line A hitting this at this point. So, whichever line we choose to use in the end, we are still going to get the same answer. So, what are we going to do here? I'll allow you to use your own initiative to see to determine what line actually is suitable for you. So I'll leave these two lines here, and I'm going to choose one shortly, and I'll tell you why I'm choosing that one. My choice could be sentimental because I have projected from the elevation. This time around, I want to project the true length from this plan view. So I'm going to take this length directly and then project this downwards. From here, you got it touches A prime, B prime. Yeah, from there, and where it touches this point, going to be the corresponding line. So I'm going to take this line off. And draw the true length of the line that I've created from this point straight to B. So this line now becomes the true length. So I'm going to label it so we know exactly what we're dealing with. Yeah, so here is it again. The line B prime, B prime, which is parallel to the line XY plane, which is my reference plane, has its true length appearing in the plan view as DB, BD, the case may be if you give respect to lettering. But the true length of that line, B prime, D prime, will appear as BD in the true length. So I'm going to project through this point. In that, we'll extend this straight. So every other line will have to take its cue from this. Have to go parallel to the line to our true length. Have to go parallel to our true length. Now we have this lines drawn this manner. The next thing to do is to draw to project through the true length to get the edge view. That's where we are now. Step two, project through the true length to get the edge view. We've projected through the true length already. Now to get the edge view, we have to create another auxiliary view. Yeah, I spoke about creating an auxiliary view, which is the next thing we need to do, post auxiliary view from the plan view. And to do that, we have to erect an auxiliary plane. And that auxiliary plane has to be perpendicular to the true length that we have created. For you to check the perpendicularity, you could actually use your protractor to construct this line. Make sure it is 90 degrees with the true length that you have created. Of course, all other lines projected through the true length will have to also be perpendicular to that particular plane. So let's start applying our rule. Here's what I already established in the first drawing that I made. I have what is called the 1-2 rule. One signifying that if you are on this plane, you have to trace one plane backward from which, from where you're going to take your measurements from. So I'll be sitting here with one, two. Now two represent two views backwards. So I'm here, two views backward count one, this view, yeah, this view, and then this one, two, with second view. So while this time here with my 1-2 rule and my two views backward, I'll be here on XY plane taking measurements from this plane to wherever all of these points in the triangle. All right, hope we understand that. So let's do this. So I'll take my compass, measure the length from here to B. The reference plane to B gives me 48. We could actually determine that from here to the dimensions given. 10 plus 38 would give you 48. So you sit on B and do the same thing. Sit on B, my compass pin at B. I'll go 38 with my arc. Sorry, 48 with my arc. Has to be from the reference plane to one reference plane to another reference plane, transferring that we have. So the next point to locate would be the point C. C is 10. So if I'm sitting on C in my auxiliary view here, I'll go 10. Up this arc. 10. Yep, that's 10. And then do the same thing for A. A from the reference plane XY is 58. So I'm going to go from A, here's my A, on my new reference plane XY, and it's 58. So I'm going to have 58. Here, right here. If you draw a straight line through all of those points, you would find out that you will have a straight line. Here, straight line, which is going to be our edge view. Yeah, right there. This is our edge view. And it is also our first auxiliary view. This is how you know you're doing the right thing. You get a straight edge view is always a straight edge, more like you're looking at a triangle flat. Okay? You're looking at it flat to yourself and you're seeing all the points, B, C, A, and all of that put together. So we'll label them again and go on to the next step. Oh yeah, so here we have our auxiliary view one, which is our edge view. From this edge view, we are going to create our second auxiliary view. So to do that, we would have to create another XY plane. This time around, would label that plane X2, Y2 plane. From each of the points from the edge view, straight lines will have to draw perpendicular. Same thing applies here. B, perpendicular. Same thing applies to point A. Draw a line perpendicular to this. This is pretty much easy if you're using your set square and your T square aligned together. You get the same thing that I'm doing here. There's nothing different. There's nothing extraordinary. It's just that we're using different tools, right? So, but or you could use a protractor. Yeah. Use your protractor to get this. It's all the same. Yep. So we can check if it's actually 90 degrees. Yeah, 90 means it's perpendicular. Here too, check for 90 degrees. All of these lines are perpendicular to the earth. So we could actually do some kind of trimming so we don't confuse the lines. This can go, we're done with this. Done with this, we're also done with this. So we have those lines to project now through the XY. Interesting. So now the same rule applies. I'll have to go from this X1, Y1 plane. Okay, I think I should label them with my second auxiliary plane drawn and labeled, and my lines further extended. Now we can deal with the second. The third step, here we're going to draw the second auxiliary to get the true shape of the lamina. So let's get on with it. This is where we are. We are at, and we're going to do the same thing, applying the second, the 1-2 rule. Applying the 1-2 rule, I would sit on this new auxiliary plane that I have, X2, Y2. I'll go back one plane and I'll be sitting here. Yep. That means this is where I'm going to be taking my measurements from. Now, with respect to this plane, where am I going to be taking my measurements from? Is it from this plane or from this particular edge view? This is where the 1-2 rule also applies. The one landed me here, X1, Y1. The two representing the view will land me one view. Then the second view will be right here. So this is where I'm going to be taking my measurements from with respect to XY, Y1 plane. So let's do that. From this point of reference to point C, I'm getting 52.6, so I'm going to take that, 52.6 on my new reference plane, go 52.6 and create an arc. That'll be my point C. I'll take another point, reference point B. B is exactly sitting on the reference plane, so that there will be no issues with that, right? I'm still going to hit the same place after all. That's the reason for doing this, so that I don't have too many lines constructed. I could actually shift this XY1 plane further so that I get some space for that. But I did that in the first video for starters. You could actually rearrange yours to be something else. So let's look at point B. Point B now. Point A, rather, sorry. Point A is 104.9, so I'm going to take 104.9 and sitting on this plane. Look at what I'm doing. A, straight, in this reference plane, I'm transferring that reference to this point. Yeah, from this reference plane. Right there. So all of these 3 points joined together will give me the true shape of the lamina that we are looking for. Do this right here. Here. So I have A here. A, I have B here. Let's go sequentially. Then I have C here. I join all those points together to be the true shape of the lamina that we are looking for. Reducing these lines to remove ambiguity and confusion, you can have this is clean, clear, and done. So I'm just going to label these and have all the parameters labeled down. The next thing to do is actually to determine the angle that this lamina makes with the horizontal plane. Like I said in the previous video, all you need to do is to find the angle that the two auxiliary planes make. Okay, as the first auxiliary and the second auxiliary. The angle that they make with each other is actually the point or the plane that the lamina makes with the horizontal. So I'm going to do this and copy that. Okay, good. 59.2. Great. Here, this is what we arrived at. AB, this line AB measures 105.5. If you're using another instrument, which is prone to errors and all of that, you could get something less than this. That's what this error advantage or tolerance is giving. And then AC, the line AC measures 76.5, the tolerance of plus or minus one. And the line BC measures 68.7 tolerance plus or minus one. This is tolerance that's acceptable in the West African examination. The angle that lamina makes with the horizontal plane, okay, explained before, is 59.2. With the adjustments and all of that, 59.2. So thank you for watching.